tutti da portare a terra. E deve essere Zimbabwe, business wise, we are going through a tough time. Things are not as well as they want them to be. We've got challenges like cash shortages. Disposable income is low, and as a result, as another market, our business is reduced as well. But I want to share with you wisdom of how we can navigate around that area. And what I'm going to say, I will speak from my book. This is my second book. I launched it the day before Easter. It was my 29th edition. I want to talk about the power of relationships. Can you all say the power of relationships?
Power of relationships.
And if you have something tonight, please write what I'm going to say. Because I'm going to say powerful things. They will transform your life, they will transform your business, they will take you to the next level.
Yes.
Relationships are more important than money. Relationships are more important than money. Your network, you've got an effect on your network. Your contract, you've got a bearing on the type of the contract you get. This will operate on relationships. The reason why I'm here tonight is because I've got a relationship with the other business forum. It's because I've got a relationship with Clement. It is not because of that relationship I would not be here. Because as I speak, I'm supposed to be a Toastmasters International Champions Club at the Court Hotel. But because I've got a relationship with Clement, I accepted the invitation to be here. I took it as an opportunity, as a privilege, to serve my club. So when times are tough, to look at ways which you can collaborate. Especially as Zimbabweans, as black people, we should know the value of collaboration. We should get to a point where we understand that 40% of an elephant is better than 100% of a rat. This selfish mentality, you're putting dealing in. We should do away with it in these tough times. Let us look at a way which we can synergize with others. I'll tell you what I've done. For instance, I can do consultants maybe in camera registration, accounting, tax, and so forth. But I know a brother who does website, logos, graphic designing, and so forth. Maybe I don't have $200 to get a website designed. What do I do? I go to him and say, look, you are good at web designing. To you, maybe it's an issue of savings, like you don't need to buy something, it's your skill. Let us do an exchange where I can do your accounts and you do my website. We've done kind of like a barter trade. So I now have a website worth $200 and I've done work for him worth $200. I haven't used any of my money. Maybe I also have a friend who's a lawyer. Maybe I need a certain memorandum of understanding drafted. What do I do? I go to him and we do have barter trade. So in this tough time, look at ways where you can do barter trade or join hands with others. Maybe you know that there is shortage of maize at a certain company here in Harare, Zimbabwe. And you know that maize is readily available in Lusaka. And you might not have the full amount to bring the whole truckload from the start. You can look for other five entrepreneurs and you combine your resources and you bring them to sacrifice and you make your money. So these are some of the things which you can do in these tough times and progress. So you should begin to build relationships. How do you build relationships? We have to be deliberate about it. You have to be intentional about it. By joining organizations such as these ones, I have a business forum where you can come and get to meet with other entrepreneurs. Other civic organizations like JCI, how many know JCI here? Talk about JCI. Write JCI down and as soon as you get to Google JCI. Organizations such as Toastmasters International and other professional associations such as Zimbabwe National Chamber of Commerce, Confederation of Zimbabwe Industries, a whole lot of organizations which you can join and begin to participate actively. When you get to those organizations, volunteer to do well. And as you volunteer, your visibility will increase. And as your visibility increases, your leadership skills are being sharpened and you are saving the humanity. Then there are other simple things, such as a business card. How many of you have business cards here? Business cards. See, a business card, it costs between 5 and 10 cents to print. But the kind of the value which it can bring to you, it's very phenomenal, it's very profound. I remember some time in 2014, I was invited to a business seminar by Winfield Services. And on that seminar, Dr. Stema Shatini was the one who was speaking. And when she finished speaking, she asked, how many of you have got their business cards? And I raised my hand. I was sitting in front and I gave her my business card. As soon as I gave her my business card, she was impressed. Well done, young man. Because you have shown me that you are serious about business and give me your money in the stress ball. She gave me money in the stress ball from 10 cents. But over and above that, I created a relationship with the air, and I co-authored a book with the air. 2 weeks down the line, I was also invited by a marketplace breakthrough, by a marketplace leadership breakfast meeting in Eastleigh. The same thing happened. We were asked to put our business cards in a bower. Then they were shuffled and the draw was made. And my card was picked. And I was given a book by Donald Trump. The book worth $20 from 10 cents. But all in about that book, I began to develop relationships. So if you are serious about business, something like a business card, it's important. It can open doors for you. Second reason why you need a business card is a business. Reason number one, it shows that you are serious about business. Reason number two, a business card is a form of advertising. Because the business card is going to tell you what you do, what you are into. Reason number three is a form of branding. Reason number four, even long after you have gone, other people can know what you do. I have a business card which I have collected as back as 2009. 2008, 2007, I have them in my office. I can still refer to those business cards and know who was at this event and what they do. another reason. A business card is a subtle way of asking someone his business card. If you meet a professional, someone who's professional with total or diplomas and all their business etiquette, and then you give him your business card, subconsciously he is obliged to give you his business card. On my birthday, I met John Tisman, the high profile corporate executive in Zimbabwe, a 5-star general in terms of business. He came to congratulate me when I went to my business. When I greeted him, I introduced myself and I gave him my business card. Immediately, he gave me his business card as well. These are big hitters in this nation. That's how I wanted to get his business card. So I encourage you to prioritize relationships. I know that relationships are more important than money. Collaborate, synergize, and be intentional about creating a relationship. And tomorrow, go and create your business cards. Thank you.
For these and other stories, visit our website www.263chat.com. Follow us on Twitter @263chat and like our Facebook page, 263chat.